tutorial Decode, and in today's class I will be dealing with double division. Now this editorial is about the diplomacy, it is about the international relations, and this will be helpful for your general studies mains examination paper 2. Now before I discuss about this editorial, it is important to understand the nature of diplomacy. Now diplomacy, it is like a truncated journey. It is like a journey in which you will achieve certain goals, in which you will achieve certain milestones, in which you will be able to meet the two undesired ends. But there will be situations, there will be times when your diplomacy may not yield the desired results. There may be situations when there will be a lot of pitfalls and there will be a lot of negatives in your diplomacy. Now, this is true also for India. We had certain positives in our diplomacy, we had certain negatives in our diplomacy. But if you look at the India's diplomacy with respect to its neighbors, and if you want to choose the positive, if you want to choose the best in which India has performed really well, it is about with respect to the India's diplomacy with Sri Lanka. That is one of the positives of Indian diplomacy. Now before I discuss about the positive aspect about India's diplomacy with respect to Sri Lanka, it is important to go to the background of the issue. Now, let me discuss this issue in the background. Now if you look at the map of Sri Lanka, this is how Sri Lanka actually looks. If you will have a look at the north and the northeastern regions of Sri Lanka, you will find that this region, it has got a different kind of a culture from the culture that the other region has. The people residing in the north and the northeast of Sri Lanka, they are distinct. Now how are they distinct? The people living in the north and the north, they are basically Tamilian. They are basically the descendants of India who have had settled in Sri Lanka. On the other hand, we have a majoritarian population of Sri Lanka. The maximum population of Sri Lanka, it is of the Sinhalese. The Sinhalese are residing in the rest of Sri Lanka. They are in majority. They have a distinct culture. They speak a different language from what the people of North and Northeast speak. And it is the human irony. It is the human irony that the humans, they hate, they abhor, they dislike the disparity and the diversity of language and religion. It is the irony of the human race that they hate the diversity of language and religion. And this has become the cause of dissension. This has become the cause of attrition. This has become the cause of antagonism. This has become the cause of jealousy. This has become the cause of war. This has become the cause of hatredness. This has become the cause of fights between the people around the world. The people, they love the diversity of gadgets. They love the diversity of the non-living. They love the diversity and the disparateness of the non-living, or something that is non-living, and something that is living and its diversity exists is hated by the human beings. And this thing has become the cause of the war and the attrition. This is the cause of the conflict in Sri Lanka. Do culture exist kar rahe hain, but wo aapas mein milke nahi reh rahe hain. Because this has become a tendency of the human race not to assimilate the diversity. You're not ready to accept the opposite. You're not ready to accept the disparate. You're not ready to imbibe the opposite. This is the cause of the conflict between the Tamilian population and the Sinhalese population. This led to disenchantment, this led to despair, this led to dissatisfaction. Whenever there is attrition between the majority and the minority chooses a wrong path. The path of direct fighting, the path of extremism, the path of militancy. This is what happened in Sri Lanka. We have seen that this Tamilian population, it had treated the way of militancy. इन्होंने उग्रवाद का रास्ता चुन लिया, इन्होंने militancy का रास्ता चुन लिया. जब भी majority और minority में problem आएगा, minority हमेशा extremism का रास्ता चुनती है. This is what is happening in India. Take the case of Naxalism. This had happened in Punjab. Take the case of Khalistan. It's minority versus majority. Majority speaks to the ballot box, minority speaks to the arms. Now this is what happened with the Tamilian population. They had, out of their disenchantment, chosen the way of militancy. And it took Sri Lankan government around 30 plus years to control this militancy, to put an end to LTTE, Liberation Tigers of Tamil Eelam. And their Prabhakaran was their head. But he got killed, the militancy was put to an end in Sri Lanka. And the positive about the Indian diplomacy is that it was because of the pressure of the Indian diplomacy that in the year 1987, an amendment to address the demands, to address the values of the north and the eastern population of Sri Lanka was introduced. The amendment was 13A amendment. This amendment promised for the devolution, for the delegation, for the decentralization of the power. कि हम आपको authority देंगे, power देंगे, आप अपना manage कीजिए. Minority जब भी exist करती है, minority disenchanted क्यों feel करती है? It feels क्योंकि उनकी demands, उनकी values addressed नहीं होती हैं. And because of this, the 13A was introduced. Oh, 13A was introduced, but till date it has been 28 years. It has been 28 years that till now it has not been properly implemented. Now India is trying to exert its pressure again on Sri Lanka. There has been a recent meet between the Indian President, Indian Prime Minister and the President of Sri Lanka, Mahinda Rajapakse, to entrench this amendment, to establish this amendment, to put this amendment into practice. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to my channel. Name of my channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 845-94-0000. If you are interested in buying the classes in the form of DVDs, pen drives and tablets. And to avail further information on the classes that I am offering, you can visit my website brainiki.com. It will also give you a lot of material to prepare for the civil services. And you can also visit another website, eiasmentors.com. Plus, click on the subscribe button so that you can subscribe to my channel. You can also share this video on your number social networking platforms that you are having, like the Facebook. You can also share it on Google+. You can also share it on WhatsApp. You can also share it on WeChat. So many social networking platforms we are having. And in case you liked this video, please click on the like button. It will increase my blood. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.